just engage in acts of charity. We must recognize that there are systems that are broken that have led to our current state of racial injustice. And that the Bible tells us very clearly that we have to pay attention to both personal sin and structural sin. Ephesians reminds us that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities. And so often racism can become internalized in ways that make us blind to the biases and prejudices that we might carry with us. We have to address the brokenness in our criminal justice system by changing policies and laws and rules. Fourth, Ferguson should inspire us to redouble our commitment to reconciliation. It is another core requirement of our faith. Apostle Paul in Galatians reminds us that there is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free. There is neither male nor female, because you are all one in Christ. This crisis has revealed just how divided and polarized our nation still is. And while we should hail some of the progress we've made in race relations, we can't do that at the expense of the real pain that still exists across our country. I have a number of clergy friends who are on their way to Ferguson tonight and tomorrow, and they're participating in a multiracial service that's happening tomorrow night in Ferguson, and then they're going to be marching on Monday in order to use their prophetic voice to advance justice. This is an opportunity to try to build new bridges across racial lines so that we can foster greater understanding and dialogue about the ongoing work of racial and economic justice in our community.